This video is sponsored by Skillshare. As Maynard sings in Lateralis, overthinking, overanalyzing separates the body from the mind. So if you're in for an out-of-body experience, strap in. Today we're looking at Tool. Also, this is definitely not safe for work, so there will be some disturbing images and subjects we'll have to talk about. You have been warned. What's up, everyone? It's Friedemann Findeisen from Holistic Songwriting. Just to prove to you that I'm actually saying words at the beginning of my videos. Welcome to the second season of the Artist Series, where we talk about the biggest rock artists in the world and what we can learn from them. This month, we're looking at Tool. And as always, let's start with a few key words. What do you think of when you think Tool? What emotions come to mind? How does the music make you feel? Take a few seconds to come up with maybe 4 or 5 words, then come back to me. Welcome back. We missed you very much. How did it go? Here's the words that I came up with. First of all, they have a spiritual vibe. They sound hypnotic, mysterious, philosophical. They feel epic, larger than life, mostly due to the sheer length of some of their songs. They have a crass sense of humor. And they sound cerebral, complex. So let's get the obvious out of the way and talk about complexity, and specifically rhythmical complexity. Yes, Tool is well known for their odd meters, and they love writing songs in 5/4, 7/8, 9/8, and even more complicated meters. The band also switches up their time signatures within their songs, like in Schism, where we have a total of 47 such switches, breaking the song into dozens of little puzzle pieces. Here's an excerpt. Schism itself talks about the dangers of breaking things apart, of separation, so musically, this fits the theme well. The song even starts with the words, "I know the pieces fit, 'cause I watched them fall away." And I think ultimately, that's what sets Tool apart from a lot of other prog bands that seek out complexity for complexity's sake. While, yes, there are some self-indulgent moments here as well, there are also a lot of musically sound choices. Let's look at another example where meter and lyrics go hand in hand. Vicarious's lyrics are about living through others, about extending our experiences through television programs. The main line is, "I need to watch things die from a good safe distance." Except for the chorus, Vicarious appears to be in 5/4, but if you look a little closer, you'll realize that it sounds more like a common meter with a 1/4 added on. That last beat sounds tacked on, as if it's not actually part of the riff. Listen again. Can you see how this makes sense thematically? A song talking about extending one's life through media that itself is extended. There's another layer to Tool's rhythmical complexity. Drummer Danny Carey is a big fan of polyrhythms, where he plays a different meter than the rest of the band. He does this more often than you think, in subtle percussion parts, for example. Listen to this. Donkeys talking, monkeys know that. So let's ask the only question that matters. How does this make you feel? To me, it seems like it loosens up the arrangement of the song. There is no clear center, no hierarchy. Like in pop music, the drums and vocals are the driving force behind everything. Here, it's not so clear. Typical for Tool, the vocals are very low in volume, and the drums, well, you heard it, they're off doing their own thing. Now, why would you want that in a song? In an interview with Aquarian, Maynard said this. "I don't think we sound machine-like. I think we may be like a clock. So is the universe. The universe is patterns that pretty much chime right in with each other." Well, he's right, their music does do that too. Each musician has their pattern, and the song we hear is the interplay of these gears clicking against each other. Before we get to my favorite part about Tool, the lyrics, let's briefly talk about harmony and melody here. If you've ever wondered why Tool sounds hypnotic, it's for a very simple reason. Their songs revolve heavily around the tonic. And while this isn't unusual for a metal band, Tool guitarist Adam Jones also uses this approach in his clean playing. Most metal bands don't even have clean sections, and if they do, they are typically used to balance out the monotony of their heavy sections, and therefore, their clean riffs use more chords. Well, here's a few very typical Tool riffs that are clean, but stick to the tonic.
I hold deep in muddy waters, you're practically raised.
Playing around the tonic like this throughout most of their songs is what gives Tool its tunnel sound. There's no added harmony, so no secondary emotions that might distract us. And when we listen to these songs for a while, which we're kind of forced to since they're so long, this creates a mesmerizing effect. Further underlining this heavy tonic sound is Maynard with his melodies, which tend to revolve around the most prominent notes in the tonic, the 1 and 5. Who else uses harmony like this? Essentially, all parts of the world that haven't been exposed to Western functional harmony. And this gives Tool an almost primal, tribal vibe. Combine that with the fact that an important characteristic of tribal music is polyrhythm, and you're beginning to understand the musical backbone of this band. Now, one of the things that can be hard to wrap one's head around is Maynard's crass intellectualism. Songs like Stink Fist, Prison Sex, Hooker with a Penis seem to send a clear message. I mean, let's be honest, you wouldn't exactly expect valuable life lessons from someone who appeared in a movie called Bikini Bandits.
Bikini Bandits, my four favorite sluts. Thank you for joining me.
In hell.
So, let's talk about crassness. When asked about their controversial single Stink Fist, Maynard had this to say. I think that there's many meanings that we really strive for within the music. There's layers of interpretation. If people want to think it's about fist fucking, that's fine. That's where they're at. But if they really look at it, and really look at us and who we are, they'll understand that we go a little deeper. Now they'll dig a little deeper, trying to find out what's really going on. So what is going on here? Let's take a look. The actual song, it seems, is about overstimulation. It starts off with the words, "Boredom's not a burden anyone should bear," and quickly goes into this. The song then builds to one of my favorite moments in Tool's discography, when for just a moment, we move away from the tonic and Maynard sings this. The message here is similar to Vicarious's. We as a generation are bored, apathetic, desensitized zombies with no sense for subtlety. So maybe what Maynard is trying to do is to alienate people, to weed out those that do not look beyond the surface, to make sure his message reaches the right people. At the same time, he also said in the aforementioned interview that our goal is non-judgment, non-filtered acceptance of everything. In Louder, he talked about Tool's frequent live shows with comedian Bill Hicks, a personal hero of mine, and why they like to work with him. We were resonating similar concepts. Unity is the philosophical center, evolution, change, internally and externally, individually and globally. That's pretty much the gist of his comedy, no matter what he was talking about. Music, porno, smoking. Whatever it was, it came back to the idea of unity and evolution. In other words, you can learn, or evolve as he likes to put it, from everything, no matter the subject. Let's go through the lyrics of one more song, one that I find particularly clever, Prison Sex. This one starts off with the lines, "It took so long to remember just what happened. I was so young and vestal then. You know it hurt me, but I'm breathing, so I guess I'm still alive, even if signs seem to tell me otherwise." So at first glance, this is about child abuse. The prison then would be a metaphor for family. The next few lines seem to take this a step further. The idea here is that this child grows up to become an abuser himself. But then something interesting happens in the next paragraph, when Maynard uses the words, "my lamb and martyr." My lamb and martyr? What's religion got to do with it? He's a writer who clearly puts a lot of thoughts into his lyrics, so why these specific words? Well, here's my interpretation. Prison Sex uses child abuse as a metaphor for passing down our beliefs to our children. So it uses rape as a metaphor for indoctrination, albeit socially accepted indoctrination. And when you see it like that, this paragraph seems to take on a whole new meaning. I've got my hands bound and my head down and my eyes closed, my throat's wide open. Visualize this. This is a person praying. So the message behind the song seems to be, make up your own mind. Don't just believe what people tell you. Break out of this mental prison. Against this backdrop, all the symbolism Tool throws at us, the third eye, ritual magic, sacred geometry, mythology, occultism, seem almost like an offer. Here's everything we have learned about the world and what people think about the world. You do with it what you will. In the words of Maynard, Tool is exactly what it sounds like. It's a big dick. It's a wrench. It's a verb. It's a digging factor. It's an active process of searching. As in, use us, we are a shovel, we are the match, we're the blotter of acid, your tool. Use us as a catalyst in your process of finding out whatever it is you need to find out, or whatever it is you're trying to achieve. If you enjoyed this video, sharing and subscribing to it would mean a lot to me, and hopefully your friends. If you'd like to talk more about Tool, I'll be doing a Q&A on the live channel next week, so make sure you subscribe to this other channel as well. As always, let me know in the comments which artist you would like me to do next. I'll be on vacation next month, and there won't be an artist series then, so this will be for 2 months from now, but of course, I'll be reading your comments. Thanks for watching, take care, and stay gefährlich. Before I let you go, a word about our sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes in music, arts, design, business, and more. So if you have no idea what I just talked about with all the notes and the words, why not head on over to Skillshare and take one of their many music theory classes? There are courses on reading sheet music, chords, scales, and keys, music theory just for electronic music producers, modes, you name it. The best thing about all this is that for all of these courses and any other courses you might want to watch, like Photoshop, After Effects, or pottery, you only pay one price. And if you sign up using the link in the description, you don't even do that. Because the first 500 people to join will get 2 months free. After that, if you choose to go for the annual plan, it's less than 10 bucks a month, which for a gazillion billion courses, my estimation, is pretty fair, I think. Go check it out. Thanks.